Welcome everybody to this tutorial. Today we are going to be talking about how to do some really great panoramic photos using Rawtherapee and a different program called Autostitch. Before we get started, I just want to remind you guys, if you want to head over to the default scene, if you like VFX and computer modeling and 3D animation and things like that, that's my channel where I put all of my VFX tutorials, so you can just search the default scene in YouTube and that will come up. Alright, so the first thing that I'm going to do is come here to Rawtherapee, and you can see I have a folder open and it's got a bunch of drone pictures that I took a little while back. And I'm just going to go ahead and you can see I've already edited some of these, so I'm going to go back to the DNG files. And I didn't save any of the processing parameters, which is nice. So that means we can kind of just start with these photos right here. And all I did is I flew my drone up to, I don't know, 200 meters in the air, and then I had it stay stationary and I just rotated it around while I was looking at while I took pictures. So I've got my pictures here, and I'm going to come over here to batch edit and exposure, and I'm just going to turn on auto levels. And I'm going to bump the saturation up to 20. I'm going to turn on sharpening. And here, let's see, the amount, I'm going to change that to 400. Turn on some local contrast. And the noise reduction, I'll turn that up to maybe 30. And since this is an outdoor shot, I'm going to turn on haze removal, but I'll take the haze removal down to 20 or so. And then the vibrance I'll turn on up to 20, and the soft light. And then finally, let me just add in a DJI Phantom Pro. I have the Phantom 3, but that lens correction profile works pretty well for me. So all that I've done, I actually went over in a previous tutorial about how to get started fast in Rawtherapee. And so these are just kind of the basic parameters that I apply to my photos if I'm just moving quickly. So if you wanted to, you could go through each photo and you could really spend a lot of time and effort and put in and really edit each photo to your liking. But this is just what I'm going to do to save time. So and then I'm just going to right click and say put to queue. And if you don't want any image loss information at all, you can change this to like a 8-bit TIFF. But I don't really care too much because this is most likely just going to be seen on a cell phone. So JPEGs are fine for me, and I'll just leave this on my desktop and click convert. And I'll come back when these are all finished. Okie dokie. So all the images have been output, and you can see here we have all of these images. Now, if you want to go ahead and head over to, you can head over to, what is this, MatthewAllenBrown.com, and go ahead and grab Autostitch. Autostitch has a free version. The paid version, you get all sorts of features apparently, but the free version still is incredibly powerful. So let's see here, where is the download link? Yeah, if you get here, the Windows free demo version. And then for me, I just go ahead and drop it into my C drive. So it just downloads a zip file, and then you extract the zip file to anywhere on your computer, and then you just double click on the Autostitch EXE. And it brings up this little window. Now, before you add in images, because if you add in images, it'll automatically start stitching them together. So before we do that, let's go ahead and hit the settings button and go ahead and just change the scale to 100%. And then I like using this multiband right here, and the panorama save to option, I'm just going to save that to the pano folder so that all of that gets put together, and it'll save a JPEG. So if you want all of that information, you can save the JPEG quality at 100%, but I'm going to leave that at 90. Just click OK, and then go ahead and open up all these images and let it go. So it says 13 images read plus play to stitch. So I'm going to just hit play, and you'll see here as it matches and stitches the images together, it's actually going to create a JPEG file right here. Okay, so the image has gone ahead and been stitched together, and you can see that when it gets stitched, Autostitch has to kind of augment the image aspect, and so you get left with these black edges. So there's two ways that you can deal with that. The first way is you can open up GIMP, which is what I'm going to do here, or you can just go ahead and recrop the image in Rawtherapee. But I'm going to go ahead and use GIMP. So I just go ahead and drag and drop this image into GIMP. And you can see that the image size is huge. We've got a width of, 20,200 pixels by a height of 3,600, almost 3,700 pixels. So this is like a very full resolution image. And apparently my highlight reconstruction didn't do too well on that particular image. And so let me go ahead and just hit Shift C and turn off my fixed aspect ratio. And then you just go ahead and crop this based on wherever the lowest corner is, because you want to keep as much of that image information as possible. So I'm going to check both of these corners. So this corner is a little bit lower, and then this corner is inside, and crop it on the bottom here too, just to get rid of that black down there at the bottom, and then bring this in as well. Hit enter, and now you can see we have a very beautiful panoramic picture. And then if this image obviously is much too large, so let's go ahead and come here to image and scale image, and let's change this to, 1080. And now we have a much more manageable image size. But it still looks great. So anyway, that is the easiest way that I know of to do really high resolution, really high level panoramic images that aren't just stitched together in your phone. I hope that this has been helpful for you guys, and if it has, I ask that you would like, comment, and subscribe. And beyond that, I hope you guys' 2021 is starting off well, and I will see you next time.